A very good morning to all the viewers. A very warm welcome to our online class. This would be a first class in history on the chapter Indus Valley Civilization. So today we are going to start with a new chapter, Indus Valley Civilization. I would request all the students to please open your textbooks and keep in front of you, and please follow my video as and when instructed. Please do mark or underline. In case you have any doubt, you can verify with your textbooks. So shall we proceed with our today's class? Shall we begin? Shall we start? So today we are going to start with a new chapter, that is Indus Valley Civilization. As I always instruct you all, or as I always tell you, before starting any chapter, it is first important to know the meaning of the heading or the title of the chapter. That will make our task more easier and more simpler to understand what we are going to study or what we are studying about. So, as the name indicates, this is a chapter related with, you know, Indus is the name of a river. So, a civilization that existed on the valley of the river Indus. But to make it more clear to understand or simpler, we need to understand the meaning of civilization. So, what do you understand by the word civilization? Civilization means nothing but it is a more developed, means of human life, social life, a more advanced stage, or an advanced stage of human life where there is a lot of social and cultural growth has taken place. So let us move on to understand the meaning of civilization in clear. If you all remember, if I'm not mistaken, in the previous class when I dealt with early humans, we taught that towards the Neolithic age, man led a more settled way of life. He left all his nomadic ways of life and he started dwelling a more settled way of life, and agriculture became his main occupation. In the Neolithic age, when agriculture became his main occupation and he started living a more settled life in settled dwellings and all, so what? They had abundance. Abundance of food crops or food grains or food supply. The food supply was in abundance. So at that time, they had more time to invest in more productive works like art and craft, right? Like jewelry making, pottery and all. So what happened? Over a period of time, they invested the time in more creative works or more creative jobs, and they became specialist at that. Yes or no? I said that was the meaning of specialization. If you remember, if you can recall, in the previous class, I told you what is the meaning of specialization. In the Neolithic age, when man led a more settled life and agriculture became the main occupation, he had food grains in abundance. So, at that time, he could invest more of his time in more productive works. So, that gave way to specialization. So, you must be thinking, what does specialization have to do with civilization? So, it is somewhat correlated. So, please look here. When man started producing enough food, enough means sufficient food, he began thinking of new things. What were they? He thought about a settled society, better food, better clothes. He also learned how to read and write. He began to improve his knowledge, to improve his life. He started taking part in leisure activities. Thus, we can say that when man looks for more, point to be noted, when man looks for more than just fulfillment of his basic needs, this stage is known as the stage of civilization. So, what do you understand from this? When man had food in abundance, sufficient food, and he had he wanted a better food, better clothes and a better way of life, they started moving towards a more developed or a more advanced or sophisticated ways of life or more advanced social and cultural aspects of life. So, the point to be noted here, thus we can say that When man looks for more than just fulfillment of his basic needs. What are his basic needs? Food, clothing, and shelter. So, we can say that when man looks for more than just fulfillment of his basic needs, this stage is known as what? As the stage of civilization. So, I hope you understood. The more developed, advanced, or sophisticated ways of life, means of life is called as civilization. So, the civilization that existed on the banks of the river Indus or on the valleys of river Indus is popularly called as or termed as Indus Valley Civilization. So, now moving on to the earliest civilizations that flourished in the world were, so other than Indus Valley civilizations, what were the other civilizations that prevailed during that time? Other than Indus Valley civilization, what were the other civilizations that existed or flourished during that time? Let us see. The Egyptian civilization on the banks of river Nile. Where did this Egyptian civilization found? On the banks of river what? Nile. The Mesopotamian civilization on the banks of the river Euphrates and Tigris. The Chinese civilization in the valley of Huanghe and Yangtze rivers. And last, the Indus Valley civilization on the banks of the river Indus. So, what were the earlier civilizations? 1. The Egyptian civilization. 2. The Mesopotamian civilization. 3. The Chinese civilization. 4. The Indus Valley civilizations. Point to be noted, if you mark or observe, each of these civilizations existed on the banks of some or the other river, like River Nile, River Indus, Huanghe, and so on. So, let us proceed. So, what is the reason behind the development of or existence of this civilization on the banks of the river? What do you think? What would be the main cause or the reason behind the civilizations? Okay. Two civilizations to be found on the banks of rivers. So, what are the reasons? Reasons for settlement near rivers. The rivers provided abundant supply of water for agriculture. Very simple, common sense, just think. Why were these civilizations found on the banks of various rivers? Why? Because rivers provide fertile land. The banks of the rivers had abundant and sufficient supply of water. They provided fertile land for agricultural purposes. They served as a cheap and easy means of communication and transport. And above all, they protected from immediate or sudden enemy attacks or foreign attacks. So now, let us see each of these points in detail. The rivers provided abundant supply of water for agriculture, as already told. The land near the rivers was extremely fertile for agriculture. It was fertile, it was rich, the soil was rich and fertile. Rivers provided means of transport and what? Communication. The river valleys did not suffer extremes of climate, means extremes of temperature. Okay, they did not suffer from extremes of climate and were warm and pleasant. They protected them from foreign or enemy attacks. So, these are the various reasons behind why all the civilizations were found on the banks of various rivers. Now, settlements sprang up on the banks of river Indus because. So, what is the reason? So, we are studying what? Today's topic of concern is Indus Valley Civilization, or the civilization that existed or dwelled on the banks of the river Indus, right? So, settlements, what? What was the reason behind settlements sprang up on the banks of river Indus? Why? Because the environment in this area was just suitable for agriculture, with ample means sufficient supply of water and warmth. The river Indus, with its annual flooding, provided fertile alluvial soil for cultivation. Every year, there were floods in river Indus. So what happened during annual floods or annual flooding, the river water brought with it a lot of alluvial deposit that made the land or the soil rich and fertile, right? Every year river Indus had annual floods. So annual flooding helped the river waters to bring with them some alluvial deposit with them that made the land or the banks of the river, the soil there rich and fertile for agriculture. Forest provided timber. Timber means wood for fuel and construction. It is important to note here that Sindh and Rajasthan were then not deserts as they are today. So what do you understand? See, point to be noted. It is important to note what? That Sindh and Rajasthan is a desert, were then not deserts as they are today. Then means, then refers to the period during when Indus Valley civilization existed. Indus Valley civilization dates back to 2500 BC to 1500 BC. So it was during that period of Indus Valley civilization, it dates back to that period. At that time, it is noted that Rajasthan was not a desert. Now period, let us study about the period or the Indus Valley civilization discovery and extent. In 1921, an Indian archaeologist, what was his name? Mr. Dayaram Shahani, discovered the ruins of the city of Harappa. In the year 1922, the following year, Dr. Rakhal Das Banerjee discovered the ruins of Mohenjo-daro in the Larkhand district of Sindh. These two discoveries nullified the old theory that history of India started with the coming of the Aryans. So what was the old theory? There was a concept or a notion or an idea that actually history began or started with the coming of the Aryans. History started with the advent. Advent means with the coming of the Aryans. But various researches in the year 1921 and in the year 1922, that is Dayaram Shahani and Rakhal Das Banerjee, in their various excavations and discoveries, proved this theory to be nullified. Nullified means wrong. So in the various discoveries in the year 1921 followed by the discovery in 1922, nullified means proved the theory wrong, or proved that the old concept, what was the old concept, that history began with the coming of the Aryans, was totally false or wrong, because much before the coming of the Aryans, there did exist a civilization called as the Indus Valley civilization. So what do you understand from this? From this we clearly get a picture or an understanding that the Indus Valley civilization existed much before the advent or the coming of the Aryans, or this was the earliest urban civilization which came to be discovered in the year, or which came to our notice in the year 1921 and 1922 by various Indian archaeologists called Dayaram Shahani and Rakhal Das Banerjee. So these two discoveries nullified, means proved wrong, what? The old theory that the history of India started with the coming of the Aryans. I hope it's clear. It brought to light the fact that a very advanced civilization, what did it provide us with? It brought to the light the fact, means it gave us the information that a very advanced civilization existed in India about 5000 years ago. Just imagine, think, 5000 years ago. As both the sites belong to the, what were the sites? Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. Harappa and Mohenjo-daro are two big cities of this Indus Valley civilization. So the two sites refers to what? One is Harappa and the other one is Mohenjo-daro. As both the sites, that is Harappa and Mohenjo-daro belonged to the Indus Valley, this civilization came to be called the Indus Valley Civilization. Why? Why is it called as the Indus Valley Civilization? Because both the sites, Harappa and Mohenjo-daro, what? Belong to the Indus Valley. Therefore, this civilization came to be called as the Indus Valley Civilization. Harappa was the first city to be discovered in India. So, this civilization is called Harappan Civilization. You can be asked a question. Why is Indus Valley Civilization also popularly called as or referred as Harappan Civilization? See, another alternative name for Indus Valley Civilization, what? Indus Valley Civilization is also called as Harappan Civilization. Why? Because this civilization is also called Harappan Civilization. Why? Because Harappa was the first city, do underline this, to be discovered in India. Indus Valley Civilization existed during the which age? Point to be noted. We studied Stone Ages are divided into four parts. The Old Stone Age or the Paleolithic Age, the Middle Stone Age or the Mesolithic Age, the New Stone Age or the Neolithic Age, the Copper Stone Age or the Chalcolithic Age. So, when does this date back to? Indus Valley Civilization dates back to the Chalcolithic Age or the Copper Stone Age. Copper Stone Age is also called as Bronze Age. Do you remember? It is referred with three names. What? Chalcolithic Age, Copper Stone Age, or Copper Stone Age is also called as Bronze Age. So, this Indus Valley Civilization or the Harappan culture belongs to which age? It dates back to the Bronze Age or the Chalcolithic Age. The Indus Valley Civilization belonged to what? Existed during which age? During the Chalcolithic Age and Bronze Age from about 2500 to 1500 BC. So, what is the period or the extent of this civilization? It dates back to 2500 to 1500 BC. The later discoveries proved that Indus Valley Civilization is the largest of all river valley civilizations which flourished during the Bronze Age. Harappa and Mohenjo-daro are considered as the most important sites of Indus Valley Civilization. So, what are the two most important sites of the Indus Valley Civilization? Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. Mohenjo-daro means, please underline this, Mohenjo-daro means dash, means mound of the dead, right? Or dash is known as Mound of the Dead. Means what? You need to write Mohenjo-daro means Mound of the Dead. Or it can also appear like this. Mohenjo-daro means dash, Mound of Dead. It can appear for name them as well. Please do underline this. It is located on the banks of the river Indus in the Larkhan district of Sindh. Harappa is on the banks of River Ravi in the Montgomery, now Sahiwal district in Pakistan. So, what do we see? More than 256 sites have been discovered in large parts of North and Central India. Rajasthan, Northwestern India, Sindh and Baluchistan. And Baluchistan, some of the important sites discovered are given in the table format below. If you can see, there's a table format here. Some of the important sites of the Indus Valley civilization and what is their location, in which places they are found. So, let us, how many sites were discovered? Not 256, more than 256 sites have been discovered, right? So, what are the sites? You can see a table here. So, some of the important sites discovered are given in the table below. So, what are the important sites? One is Lothal. Where is it? It is situated in Gujarat. Kalibangan in Rajasthan. Rupar, Punjab. Banwali in Haryana, Alamgirpur, Uttar Pradesh, Mohenjo-daro, Sindh, present-day Pakistan, Harappa in Sahiwal district of Pakistan. So, point to be noted. There is a note here. Please see. I am giving you with some extra information that is not mentioned in your books or that is not given in your textbook. So, what is the point to be noted? The Harappan culture belongs to which age, children? It dates back to from 2500 BC to 1500 BC. It belongs to the Chalcolithic age or the Bronze age. Bronze had been discovered by the people of the Indus Valley civilization. So, who discovered bronze? It is believed that bronze was discovered or invented by the people of the Indus Valley civilization. So, people who work with bronze, who make bronze are called as bronze smiths, right? People who make ornaments, gold ornaments are called goldsmiths. Similarly, people who work with bronze or make bronze are called as bronze smiths. Mixed what? Copper and tin. They mixed copper and tin to form an alloy, and that alloy was called nothing but bronze. So, bronze was made out of copper and tin. Bronze smith mixed copper and tin to form the alloy bronze. Bronze statue of a dancing girl had been found at Mohenjo-daro during excavations. I told you what is the meaning of excavation, khudai, right? So, it is believed that this Indus Valley civilization dates back to 2500 to 1500 BC. It existed during the Bronze Age or the Chalcolithic Age because many bronze smiths, or it is believed that the people of the Indus Valley civilization discovered bronze by mixing up copper and tin, making an alloy called bronze. And one such evidence is the statue of a dancing girl, or a bronze statue, means the statue is made of bronze. The bronze statue of a dancing girl has been found where? At Mohenjo-daro during excavations. See, this is how it looks. Image. The bronze figure of a dancing girl, Mohenjo-daro. This is how it looks. This is a bronze. This statue is made of bronze. Bronze is an alloy made of copper and tin. This is a bronze statue of a dancing girl that was discovered during excavations, or that was found in excavations at Mohenjo-daro. Okay, excavations at Mohenjo-daro revealed as a bronze statue of a dancing girl. Now, sources. So, what are the sources of information about the Indus Valley civilization? From where do we get the information regarding all the information regarding Indus Valley civilization? What are the sources of information? Two, either through excavations, that is khudai, or through inscriptions, that are writing. So, let us see sources. We come to know about the Indus Valley civilization from archaeological sources through excavations and inscriptions. Inscriptions are writings. Excavation means khudai karna. Script. The Indus Valley people had developed the art of writing in the form of pictographic script. So, what was the script, children? The Indus Valley script was mainly pictographic. Pictographic means the script was represented in the form of pictures, symbols, shapes, and designs. What do you understand by the word pictographic? Point to be noted. The Indus Valley script was mainly pictographic in nature. It was a pictographic script means the script was not in writing of a present day in alphabets. It was more of pictures, signs, and symbols. Therefore, we call it a pictographic script. But there is no point because the script could not be deciphered. What do you mean by deciphered? What is the meaning? Deciphered means it could not be understood or it could not be read. Right? What is the point? You get a script but you cannot read anything. You cannot guess anything out of it. You cannot make any information out of it. It was not deciphered means it could not be read. Or it could not be understood. Okay, exactly what it meant. They were only just wild guesses. So, what do you understand by the script? The script of the Indus Valley people was pictographic. It was a pictographic script and it could not be deciphered by many of the historians. Means it could not be read or exact information could not be gathered. The Indus Valley people had developed the art of writing in the form of pictographic script. Nearly 400 signs have been found, but it has not been deciphered so far, and therefore continues to puzzle, means confuse, scholars and historians even today. So what is the meaning of deciphered? Deciphered means historians have not been able to read the script. See, this is how it looked. This is a picture of a seal. I will proceed further and I'll tell you what is a seal. I'll explain the meaning of a seal. Just see, this is how the script looked like. See, it is pictographic in nature. What did I say? What is the meaning of pictographic? Means in the form of pictures, signs, symbols and different shapes. See, can you read anything out of this? Can you understand? This was more in the form of pictures or images, right? So the script was somewhat like this, pictographic in nature. Now, seal. What is a seal? A seal is a rectangular or a square tablet made of clay. Means a seal was rectangular or square in shape. At times it was even circular as well. But most of the time it was found in a rectangular or a square shaped tablet made out of clay. So a tablet that was made out of clay, which was in rectangular shape, was called a seal. Seals. Square or rectangular tablets made of clay are called seals. Just now I told you, I mentioned, right? Seals are the most important findings. Findings means discoveries of the Indus Valley civilization. As many as how many? 2000 seals have been recovered from various Indus Valley sites. We studied Lothal and all the various Indus. There are more than 256 Indus Valley sites. So during excavations Khudhai, so what was found? More than 2000 seals were discovered or invented. Okay, during excavations in the various Indus Valley sites, more than 2000 seals were found that belong to the Indus Valley civilization, have been discovered from various Indus Valley sites. Seals are an important source of information. Regarding what? Regarding socio-economic, means social life, economic life, socio-economic, cultural and religious life of the Indus Valley people. They throw light on the beliefs, artistic skills and trade contacts as well. So what is these seals? They throw light means they give us information about the various spheres of life of man during the Indus Valley age. Mainly, they reveal us or give us information about the social life, about the religious life, about the cultural life and about the various trade contacts of men during the Indus Valley period, or the men of the Indus Valley period. It tells us about the trade contacts. What? Some of the seals tell us that the Indus Valley people, I'm extremely sorry, I repeat, people of the Indus Valley civilization carried out foreign trade. They carried out foreign trade. How do we know? Because many seals, many Indian seals were found in Mesopotamia. In a similar way, many Mesopotamian seals, the present day Iraq, okay, many Mesopotamian seals were also found in India. I told you a seal is a square or a rectangular clay tablet. It is morely pictographic in nature. Just in the previous slide, I showed you the picture of a seal. It had all pictures and images. I told you the script is pictographic in nature. So many seals during excavations, more than 2000 seals were discovered from various Indus Valley sites. Right? We have more than 256 Indus Valley sites and more than 2000 seals, or nearly 2000 seals were discovered in the excavations. So what does this seal tell us? They throw light or give us information about the social, cultural, religious and trade life of men during the Indus Valley civilization, or they throw light on the various spheres of life of man. What do we understand from this? From these seals we get information that people of Indus Valley civilization did trade with people of the Mesopotamian civilization, because many Mesopotamian seals were discovered in Indus Valley sites in a similar round or discovered in the Mesopotamian sites or in the Mesopotamian civilization. Many of the seals carry short inscriptions. Inscriptions are writings, brief writings, short inscriptions with pictures of one-horned bull, buffalo, tiger, elephant, goat. See, one-horned bull, buffalo, tiger, elephant, goat, etc. Right? If you go back to the previous slide, see, you can see a picture here. This is a picture of an elephant, right? This is a picture of a buffalo. This is a picture of a tiger. And this is a picture of a single horned or a rhino, right? So with pictures of one horned bull, buffalo, tiger, elephant, goat, etc. Seals were also used by merchants to mark their goods. Mark means like a trademark, to stamp. Present day we put a seal. Or we put a stamp, right? On the documents, we put a seal or a stamp. In those days, because there were no seals and stamps, these seals were used to mark. These seals were used as a trademark to mark. Seals were also used by merchants to mark their goods. The seals had animal figures and pictures like signs on them. Just now I showed you in the previous slide, what did the seals have? They had animal figures and picture like signs on them. I hope this class was clear to all of you. So, this is a very lengthy chapter. I would like to divide this chapter into three sequels or into three parts. This was the first part of Indus Valley Civilization. This is the first video. There are two more videos to be that would be uploaded very soon. That would be following this video. There are two more videos to follow this video that would be uploaded very soon. So this was the first part of Indus Valley Civilization for grade 6 students. I hope you could understand. It was clear to all of you. Okay. Thanks for watching. Goodbye. Have a good day.